just about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Both teams are on the field, and we're just about ready to open things up. From his own goal line, he's to the 20. Brought down at the 27-yard line. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. They come out in a 5-wide set. Tackle made at the 38.
Well, the quarterback's able to find a soft spot in the defense, and he threw an accurate ball for a solid pickup.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 38.
Here we go.
Here. He's taken down at about the 35.
The object was to sell the pass and then sneak by the defensive line with the run. The problem here was that the quarterback didn't sell the pass very well.
Out of bounds at about the 45. Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
Ready.
Throws it to the halfback on the screen, and down he goes around the 48-yard line.
The quarterback dumped it off, and everyone did a good job of blocking up front. Doesn't get much better than that.
He's scrambling. Slides down to the ground.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That makes it second and six.
It's second down, 6 to go. Ball on the 47-yard line.
Pick it up, pick it up, pick it up.
Throws out to the back, and it's through his hands.
Number 22, unintended receiver on the play. That'll bring up third and six.
There was some movement on the line.
False start. Offense.
It'll be third down again after that penalty.
Yeah, now they have more yards to pick up for the first down.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 42. Catches it, and he's looking for more. They'll bring him down at the 30.
This guy's got the combination of smarts and reliability that makes a receiver really dangerous. No wonder he's looked to on third down.
Here's the 8th play of the series. Brought down around the 8-yard line. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. And they'll run him again. He tackles him for a loss.
If these defenders continue to exploit the O-line like that, it's going to be a long day for this running back.
This is the 10th play of this drive. And he's taken down at the 3-yard line. Running up about 8 on the draw. So here we go. It's third and goal from the 3-yard line. The Broncos running back down there on the sideline. He was injured earlier. He means a lot to this offense, but I think he's going to be able to come back in. Looks like he's
touchdown, Western Michigan.
converts the extra point. An 11-play, 77-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Northern Illinois' offense really centered around this quarterback, and as he goes, the team seems to go, Kirk.
Brad, over the weeks, I've been watching him on film, and one thing I've seen is his ability to make good decisions. I mean, time after time, he just avoids the mistakes. And when you can do that as a quarterback and as a leader of an offense, you're going to move the football down the field.
And they make the stop at the 27. At the 35-yard line.
I like how efficient the offense looked on that play. Everybody knew their assignment, and it all came together for a nice run.
He makes his way to about the 48. He fights forward to around midfield.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 8.
Almost picked off.
You know, as a defender, anytime you're not going to have a chance to get to the quarterback, one of the things all defensive coaches try to teach their defense is to get your hands up and try to knock the football away. And that time, that's exactly what they did to set up this 4th down.
And he's got to be happy with that punt, Kirk.
Yeah, Brad, that was nice. So now they're looking at a long way to go to even think about a score. I was really impressed with their last series. They came out with a focus on the passing game, and the offense got the job done. We'll see if they have the same strategy here.
Quick throw out to the receiver. He's tackled right around the 28-yard line. It's 1st and 10. Ball on the 28-yard line. Western Michigan up 7 points. Gets to around the 42. Complete. He's got space to work, and he tackles him hard at the 48-yard line. How about that play?
That's a good pickup there. He just dropped back and delivered a nice throw.
They're about 4 yards away here on 2nd down. Passes to the wide out, and he can't pull it in. To his receiver. He's still moving, and he's tackled right around the 22-yard line. From the 22-yard line, it's 1st down. Quickly, touchdown. And he tacks on the extra point. We've played one quarter. Western Michigan in front, 14-0. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20, makes it to the 22-yard line. We welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Fires it out. Tackle made at about the 31. Defensive coordinator anticipating this five-wide set, and he comes in with his dime package. He tries to buy some time, and he can't get away from the pressure.
That's a loss of 5 yards. Third down.
Now it's third and six coming up. Ball on their own 26. Scrambling around. And they bring him down for a sack on the play. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Makes the grab past the marker, and it's the senior. And he shoved out of bounds around the 23-yard line. What a great play.
This is the timing that we talked about in the pregame that they must have in order to be successful with their passing game. That time, the quarterback threw it to a spot, and his receiver was there to make a nice grab.
From the 23-yard line, first down. Complete. He's got room. What a play, and that is first and goal. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Takes it right side for a good game. Dives forward. He gains a couple of yards on the carry.
With the safety coming up making plays near the line of scrimmage, that tells your offense they've got to start throwing the ball to keep them honest.
The defense backed up into their own end zone. It's third and goal from the one. Diving for extra yardage. Pick up of a yard for the tailback. Touchdown, Broncos. The PAT. A six-play, 51-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. So our score, 21-0. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. It's still only the second quarter, We've got a lot of football left, but I got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. Gets to about the 27-yard line. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. Throws it away.
Strong showing by the defense. You always like to get the other team's offense off the field as fast as you can.
He's to the 40. He's tackled at the 47. The Broncos are just cruising through this first half, Herbie. Really a comfortable lead here.
Yep, but still a lot of football left to be played. They got to remember that it's a four-quarter game, and even though that first half went pretty well, things can change in a hurry.
Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being. They go with a screen here, and the halfback's got it. He gets hit out of right around the 34.
That's a smart call to exploit the pass rush and open up some space for him. The blockers did a good job of selling that play.
First and 10. Ball on the 34-yard line. That's a great tackle at the 26.
Number 15 brings him down at the 26-yard line. That makes it second and 2.
Going for it all to the end zone. Doesn't get there.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
So the officials taking a look at this play to see if the receiver got a foot in bounds.
Regardless of the outcome of this review, I still think that this guy made an excellent catch.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So they'll overturn the call and rule this a completion.
There was a bad call made on the field, but they were able to fix it because of the replay. This is exactly why the booth review is a great thing for college football.
He makes the PAT. A quick two-play, 27-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result. Western Michigan ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. He got hit hard. The defense shut him down on their last drive, forcing a quick punt.
I don't know what these guys have to do to get back on track, but they need to try something.
He's on the run. He's brought down in the open field.
Well, they didn't pick up the first down, but he saw that no one was open, so he made the right decision to tuck it and run.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Quick pass, tight end, and he wasn't ready for it.
Number 83 was the intended receiver on the play. Third down.
Check 83, ball's going 83. Mike, here we go.
Takes it, and he's tackled short.
That is exactly the type of play that good linebackers make on a regular basis. And if you can make enough of them in college, probably going to get a chance to play at the next level.
And watch out, they're going to bring the heat right here. He's pushed out of bounds at the 42-yard line. Nice yardage on the run back. They went for it on fourth down on their last possession and weren't successful.
And this offense comes out on the field again after being stopped on downs the last time out. And not only does that affect them in a negative way, but you know what it does is it gives this defense that they're facing a ton of confidence and a lot of momentum as they come back out on the field.
Quick pass. He's taken down right around the 48-yard line. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Western Michigan comes to the line holding that commanding lead. He's going to try and scramble. And down he goes around the 40-yard line. He's scrambling, and he's going to come up with a sack.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
He scrambled. They bring him down. Throws it.
Number 82, the intended receiver on the play.
So they're going to go for it here. One more play now before we hit halftime, so they'll most likely throw one towards the end zone here. Throws incomplete, intended for his wideouts. The offense will be hoping for a little more success than they had the last time out.
This offense needs to start playing some emotional football.
Here comes the pressure. They'll head to the locker room in a game that's not even close. Western Michigan in front, 28-0.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Perhaps the most important statistic in any football game is turnover margin. I once had a wise coach tell me that it was so important they named the game after it. Whatever that means. I think it means that you're not supposed to let it get away from you and give it to the other team. And so far, both of these offenses have done a great job of that.
No doubt. And most games are lost, not won. And it's because of the turnover differential. And you can look at the stats when you say that every single time. But, you know, both teams doing a good job taking care of it. Both offenses executing and still calling a game, still scoring points, still putting up good numbers, but at the same time taking care of the pigskin. And they better value that thing because, yeah, you give it away and bad things happen.
Just about ready to start the second half. We're going to watch all the games around the country, including some coaches who like to sample the surface that they're playing on. I'll keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the cafeteria. You want some turf, some AstroTurf in there?
Yeah, if they've got some, I'll chew on that in the second half. Here's the second half for you to chew on with Brad and Kirk.
Very lopsided first two quarters. We'll hope for better as we head into the third. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 28. The Broncos continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
I hope they show some fight here and try to stay competitive. If you're going to get blown out, you at least want to go down swinging. He's got it with room to run. And he is drilled at the 35. Quick throw, incomplete, wanted his receiver. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. He's at midfield. Good open field tackle.
Makes the tackle. That's a gain of 16 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Mike 51! Mike 51!
Shift. Brought
down
at about the 27-yard line. Now he's scrambling. Slides down. And he's taken down at the 11-yard line.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That'll make it 7-7.
Throws a bullet over the middle. Big play, and it's first and goal.
Number 9 brings his end at the 2-yard line. That makes it first and goal.
They'll bring him down around the 5-yard line.
A good tackling safety is key for any defense. And if they can diagnose a play, this guy can, he can be a real menace.
It's the 9th play of the drive. They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. Throws to the receiver, got it for the touchdown.
That's a positive for the passing game. It was absolutely the right call in that situation.
And he converts the extra point. A 9-play, 73-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
So the score now, 28-7 from his own goal line. And he's tackled at the 29. We're about set to start things up again. Down immediately. Second down and 5. Ball on the 35-yard line. They come out on an empty backfield. Tackle right around the 40. Play and he'll lose yards.
No gain on the play. That'll bring up second and 11.
From their own 40-yard line, it's second down.
Let's go.
Trying to set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback, and they make the stop at the 42. Receiver incomplete.
It might not be a lot of fun, but when you're a receiver, you've got to be able to take some hits and hang on to the football. It's just part of the game.
Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick.
Not great, but not bad either. As long as your main priorities are not turning the ball over and establishing solid field position, then you're heading in the right direction.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. And he's tackled at the 41-yard line.
Number 16 on the tackle at the 41-yard line. First down.
tackle at the 47-yard line. Again with a carry. Tackle made at about the 47-yard line. And that play was snuffed out from the get-go.
You're right. It's a delayed handoff to the tailback, and the defense wasn't fooled at all there.
Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. He's taken down at the 31-yard line.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
Some open field. He's at the gains his way to the 13-yard line.
Gain of 18 yards. First down.
He has some room. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. They're not done yet.
It shouldn't have surprised these guys to see the run coming at them, but they just stop it.
Tacks on the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 25-yard line. Northern Illinois is playing much better on the defensive side of the ball here in the third quarter.
Well, Brad, I think what I've seen is they were just doing too much in the first half. They've streamlined their attack, and I think it's made it a little bit easier for their players to understand what to do, and they're playing a lot faster.
They're set to go for another round. Hands it to the back. Tackle outside after a nice pickup. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. He's knocked out of bounds at the 39. Defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
From their own 39-yard line, second down. Tailback brought down for a loss. So at the end of three, the Broncos lead 28-14. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Give it to their offense. They've got the opportunity. That's all they could ask for. Didn't get all of that one. And as the defense comes back out, you can be sure they're thinking about that score they surrendered the last time around. 47-yard line. Makes it out to midfield. 3 yard gain by the running back.
That'll make it 77.
Mike 51. Mike 51.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That's a D7 play. First down.
51, Mike. Mike 51.
Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line.
That's good for 83 yards. That'll make it 77.
And now he's got room to run. Good tackle there in space.
That's a
first down.
They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. They got him for a loss.
This is just a nice play by the defense. They're not fooled at all in this draw play.
That makes it second and
so 10. It's second and 10. Ball on the 32. Nice run up the middle. A 5 yard pickup by the halfback on the misdirection. Huge play, and now they're in a great position to score. Tries to scramble, but he's sacked.
It's a big-time effort sack by the defensive end. I want to also give some credit to the coverage downfield. The end never gave up on the play, but because the quarterback didn't have anywhere to go with the football, it gave the defensive end enough time to eventually chase the quarterback down for that sack.
And this is the 10th play of the drive. Well, after that injury, we'll get to see the backup quarterback here. They give to the tailback. Touchdown, NIU. Splits the uprights with the extra point. Northern Illinois is ready to kick it away. Fielded at the 4. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. 5 wide. Gains his way to the 36-yard line. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Gets it out to about the 47-yard line.
You like to see a team having success like this running the football. It can really open up things for the offense.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 47-yard line. They'll run it. He fights forward to about the 49. A yard, maybe 2 on the carry.
And that was the sophomore linebacker there who was able to get in and make that tackle.
He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. The running back gets 2 on the carry. The Huskies using their 3rd and last timeout. handoff up the middle. Gets to about the 47-yard line. Right now, he wants to get this kick away and change field position. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Huskies have got to be just a little bit careful that they lean too much on a star player here in this stage of the game.
Yeah, but having a quarterback that understands what this defense wants to try to do to slow this offense down is very, very important. Now you just got to stay calm, make good decisions, and move his offense down the field.
Under a minute left. It's caught. First down, and he's out of bounds.
Keep those chains moving. Just a simple out route that time, and it was enough to beat the zone defense.
First and 10, ball on the 32-yard line. Throws complete, and he stopped immediately. And he stops the clock with a spike. Makes the grab and steps out right away. First and 10. Ball on the 48. Got a man. Watch out here. Very good tackle in space. Spikes the ball. This could be it, fellas. It's fourth down. For all of you watching, it's been a great game, and it has a chance to be even greater. Will the prayer be answered? It's time for the Hail Mary. He's going to go for the home run, and he's tackled right away. The spike will stop the clock. They're at the two. Second down. Over the middle to his tailback. Touchdown, Huskies. Well, if ever there was a big extra point to be had, then this is it. To go to overtime. Looks like they didn't get the playoff quick enough. As expected, they'll call a timeout here and try to add a little pressure. And this is the biggest extra point that this young man will ever have to kick in his life. This for overtime. We're going to OT. That'll do it for regulation, and we are going to settle this one in overtime. And we're back ready now for overtime. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Fires across the middle. They'll bring him down at about the 15-yard line. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. Brought down at the 10-yard line. Come out in a five-wide set. Gets to about the 8-yard line.
That's good for 2 yards. That brings up second and goal.
From the 8-yard line, it's second down. Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. Touchdown, Western Michigan. Converts the extra point. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 25. Setting up blockers, or running backs got it on the screen. Tackle at about the 21.
That makes it 7-6.
Man left, man left. Three down. Mike 51.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And he's taken down right around the 18-yard line. Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Flips it middle to the running back. What a play to set him up with a first and goal. Got it to his man on the screen. And they push him out at the 5-yard line.
That's a gain of 4. That brings him second and goal.
Mike 51. Run, Jeff. Slam.
Trying to set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback.
That makes it third and goal.
This is from the 5-yard line. It's third and goal.
Mike 51. Ready.
There's a strike complete. Tackle made at the 1. Quickly, and they got it. Touchdown. So with their backs against the wall, they find a way. Get ready for another overtime, folks.
There is nothing more exciting than watching 4-down football in overtime. What a game today.
We'll be tied with the extra point. And he hits the PAT.
Both offenses did well responding to the early pressure of overtime. Now we'll see who can play better defense.
From the 25-yard line, first down.
Attack,
Throws it out right to the running back.
Decisive at all on that option. Once he kept it himself, there was no place to go.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 15. He gets it up, and it's good.
I know they would have rather put the ball in the end zone, but this is still big. Points are points. I think their defense is going to thrive under the circumstances.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. It's picked off, and that's the game. Northern Illinois staff just dancing on the sideline. Their star player came through for them, and they couldn't be happy.
Well, the staff has to feel good. The entire team should feel good. And I know you and I just having a chance to sit back and watch this young man play. Just an outstanding performance and something that this entire team will be able to build on.
So that wraps things up for us. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.